Who gets post-polio conditions and what are they? Post-polio conditions can only be developed in those who are exposed to the polio virus. Those most likely to develop post-polio conditions are those who had flu-like symptoms or worse when they came in contact with the polio virus when young. Even those who did not develop paralysis or weakness can develop post-polio conditions. It is important to note that post-polio conditions are not contagious, are not passed down in a hereditary way, and they are not a condition that causes death. This means that caring for persons who have post-polio conditions does not put the carer at risk, and the children of those exposed to polio do not develop these conditions from their parents. What are the post-polio conditions? Post-polio conditions are post-viral, categorized as neuromuscular, have highly variable symptoms, and are chronic and progressive. The two conditions are late effects of polio and post-polio syndrome. They present as a gradual progression of impairments in areas affected by the polio virus, as a consequence of that early damage. The health changes which develop can be biomechanical, from decades of asymmetrical movement patterns, or neurological, a decrease in the nervous system's ability to control body systems as it should. Most people think of polio as a disease that causes paralysis and muscle or limb deformity. This is only true for those who were most affected by the virus and survived the infection. We know that the polio virus also causes damage to other regions of the nervous system besides just the control of leg and arm muscles. The bulbar region of the brain is one such area. It controls many vital functions our bodies carry out, such as breathing, sleeping, and body temperature control. Damage to many different nerve cells may have occurred at the time of someone's acute polio infection, but it may have been undetected by the person and their doctors. This is called subclinical damage. The cluster of six symptoms experienced by those exposed to polio have a delayed onset. Here they are listed. Some are quite common types of symptoms, but it is in their qualities and the cluster of them together which is unique for post-polio conditions. These symptoms start to be noticed after several decades, when people are aged in their 30s to 50s. But changes can occur as early as 15 years after recovering from an acute polio infection. The six symptoms can affect a person exposed to polio's quality of life and their ability to perform tasks or work at a previous level. Each individual experiences a unique combination, intensity, and impact of the symptoms, and each symptom can fluctuate or worsen at a different rate over time. These changes can affect these people's confidence, their roles in their families, and their participation in their communities. Because the symptoms vary quite a lot for an individual exposed to polio, and also vary a lot across all the individuals exposed to polio, recognizing a post-polio condition can be quite challenging for people exposed to polio and for their doctors. What can you do now that you know this? You can help raise the awareness of these conditions. Tell older people in your family and community about post-polio conditions. If you work in medicine or health, you could also seek the experience of those you work with. Ask your peers and teams about polio-exposed people they may have worked with. Thanks for taking the time to watch this video. By understanding post-polio topics, you are helping to improve health outcomes. Visit Polio Australia's website for further information and to download resources.